I second that.
There you go. Don't feed it.
Do you know, do you already have their money in your account?
We're gonna talk about this, but no, I don't.
I can keep that and give it to Caroline, because I didn't have it with me when I saw her on Friday, so.
Well, I can give it to Caroline, I just wanted to make sure he had it in his record.
I do not have it in my record, but that's what we're gonna talk about. We'll put it here.
Yes, we have a flow of interesting paperwork.
Okay.
We don't have any minutes to approve, do we?
We do. The ones from 2 weeks ago, that I sent you 2 weeks ago, and I have minutes here.
I just gave them for her.
They're not very long.
So.
Is that from last week?
This is from 2 weeks ago, and then I sent out the ones, didn't I?
From the other meeting.
From the previous meeting, were those accepted?
Yeah, at the last meeting.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, sorry.
We don't want to do that now, right?
No, we don't.
We should table those.
So you called to order at 7:15?
And you just passed them over to me?
Yeah.
Alright. Did you have the agenda?
I have, I didn't print it out for you, I'm sorry. I was way behind schedule. So we're gonna, so you're up next, staff, applicants hiring, but if you want to take that time too to talk about what you talked about, Caroline, that'd be great.
Okay, so, well, I mean, it kind of involves people, but you know, as we go through this process, we all need to, we're kind of taking baby steps to figure out how we do things exactly. So right now, Caroline, we discovered, needs to have a receipt. Basically, the receipt for our camps can't leave the office is what we're discovering. So now, before, when you get the registration, she's photocopying the first sheet and leaving the original receipt in a folder. So that, because, so yeah, I know, Lester, we kind of went, so the auditor, the town auditor needs to have, she basically needs the duplicate receipt for herself, and the town auditor needs the other receipt for him.
When you say receipt, are you talking about the registration form that they sent you?
No, she writes out
She writes an actual receipt out for when people are paid. So the confusion really right now is that we have some people are just sending in registration fees, so, and then, which is fine, but they're gonna need a second receipt on top of their, then, so I have a.
So whatever money is received after that.
Right, so I have two folders in her drawer now, that one is paid in full and one is pending.
Okay.
So, and that would be just the ones with the $35 registration fee.
Okay.
So the ones, the things that I'm handing to you, I have left the original. So I think I'm just gonna be the one to go in and grab those.
So for example.
And you guys are probably like, what the heck are they talking about? But.
So for example, this one for this name here. So I'm assuming.
They sent in a check for $42.
Okay, so how do I know this? So that I can put it, because I keep track of how much they've sent in and how much they owe. So what Caroline was gonna do is put, well, I was gonna come in and write down on this how much I've received. So if she's handing in 42.
You know what's kind of weird is I did that for everybody else on the camp. Everything else you've written on, right? See, I wrote on that.
Yep. I think
so
everybody else I have.
Sorry.
So that, it doesn't matter to me. I just need to, as long as, if I have these, that's great. I just
well,
need.
Well, they haven't paid in full, so I know that. So that
yeah,
might
so
be why they wrote, so it was.
Yeah, why did I write that here? But I still need to keep track of
right.
How much I'm getting.
You didn't take a receipt from them yet?
No. That's the first time
okay.
I've seen this one. So as long as I have
I feel like I'm snooping in on a personal conversation.
Sorry. We're trying to, because I know we are trying to keep it basically the two of us kind of.
So you guys are figuring out receipts and way to manage that.
But you can do the.
Yeah, another time.
On the side, on the side, well, I don't want to say on the side.
So. So if you.
That's fine.
Discussion ensued.
What ended up happening, this is what I've got.
You met with Carolyn about.
Yes.
Receipts and that she has to keep money flow.
Right, and that we cannot keep the receipt now, which we thought we were going to.
And so, camp receipts must stay with Caroline.
Yeah.
And some registrations are coming in partial and others are coming in full.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so we'll figure out that, that little flow.
Yeah, we'll take that.
All right. The other thing, like you talk about applications, so we got,
Are you notifying the parents that we received your application?
See, that is a part of the next step that I was going to ask you.
So I'm doing that, actually.
Okay.
Great.
Yeah.
As long as the parents know that they're signed up.
Well, and it was very interesting, because did you, I don't know if she sent that email to me, but the woman who paid in full, she sent me an email that said, I sent him my money, I just wanted to make sure that I had a spot.
She does, yeah, she most certainly does. She's the only
first one that I told her about. So I sent that thing, I'm like, oh yes, thank you, we got it.
We're going to squeeze you in.
Yeah, we're going to squeeze you in.
So I already had like a thank you, in fact, I meant to do all that last night, and I didn't get around to it.
Okay.
So we have the whole time, and the list of people I need to thank.
And then to go on with that is that maybe at some point we need to go into the camp pending, saying you have paid your registration, if you would like to make the deadline for the early bird, that needs to be done by May, whatever.
Yep, so that's why I have
to.
I actually, just so everybody knows, I do have, I'm keeping track of everybody, like what they've sent in, what they owe, and I have it on my calendar to notify people, like this is how much you still owe, blah, 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 your deadline's coming up, so I will keep on top of all of that.
So when something comes in, then should we make sure that, you are making sure that you get it, so maybe that needs to, so you are going to send out a confirmation that we received your check and whatever?
Yes.
Okay.
May 12th, right, is the
May 12th,
the first early bird deadline.
How many total campers do we have registered so far? You know?
Well, so I included your children, my son, Jody's, and I think Blythe. With them, there's 18. It's a total of 18. We have 4 pre-camp and 2 post-camp.
Okay, hold on. So 18 total registrations
in. Yep, total children.
Anybody out of town yet? Because you should have one.
And how many pre-employees did we have?
When we were done.
4.
4 pre, and you said 2 post?
Yes. All right, let me see if I've got out of towners.
I don't know if the pre-post is going to be.
Okay. I don't. I don't have a registration for any out of towners.
Okay, she's open, so I'll call it for her. Oh, and that's pretty much what I'm going to say, too.
And so one of our counselors, and this might be a, we got an application, and I spoke with her about she wants to do something part-time. So we'll have to figure out how that all works in the schedule, but she was more available for 2 days out of the week because she's nannying the other 3 days.
Really?
So there you go. Maybe if you wanted to flip-flop with that, we could have a full employee.
Definitely somebody we'll want to keep on, keep in mind, just, you know.
Absolutely.
If, you know.
Right. Or even if we could give her, you know, if there's a busy day or a field trip day or something that,
true.
You know.
She's only available field trip days.
She said some Tuesdays, I think. So I think.
What's our field trip day?
Tuesday.
Tuesday and Friday.
She's available
Tuesday. So she's available Friday and not, and some Tuesdays. So.
She's our Friday.
Perfect.
Extra person.
So, and there are two kids that aren't available to even meet till after May. May 8th. For an interview, even.
Oh, they added step town or out of state or whatever.
So, you're scheduling two interviews to come after May 8th?
I haven't scheduled them, but that was, the conversation was basically I wouldn't be home until May 8th.
Do a Skype or a phone interview for him.
Those are things I want to do.
Have the kids show you how to do that.
And they, and they would be counselors?
Yes. And we have our, Jody, I just want to confirm with you, we had our first under 18 counselor apply this past week.
Now, have any of these people prior employment history?
No. The only one is your daughter.
Oh, great, now that one's on tape.
So what she's sitting over there.
So for the under 18, they were supposed to submit three letters of recommendation, right? Not just three people. Okay, so
we can call them if they gave three people.
We just need three.
Call them for the recommendation.
I mean, if they're the perfect candidate, but they didn't send three letters.
They didn't do three letters, but so maybe I could follow up with. I think I just wanted to be clear which one is what we wanted for.
Yeah, when you call the people, say, could you just send me a letter or email me or something nice?
Okay.
So.
It doesn't have to be in the whole either. Just a nice paragraph probably, right?
Send me, send me an email of recommendation for XYZ person.
Just so you have a record of
it.
All right.
Because that's not normal business practice anyway, so when they ask their parents, they're like, what do I do? And their parents just say, write down records, probably. Mm-hmm. So.
Is that what we
That's easily that? Overcome.
But I thought we had that listed on the application on the website, didn't we?
Mm-hmm.
That if you're...
Yep, if you're under 18, you're...
Three letters.
It said 16 to 18 required. Yeah, recommendation. They could be related to Lester, it's just not reputable for us.
Point made. 2 points, Jody.
This all check out with 3 and a half.
Right.
So how many?
So still looking. So right now, so we have our assistant director.
Do we have any
potential recommendations? So it doesn't say letter.
Doesn't say letter.
Do we have any more potentials for a director?
I got a phone call from one person, and I was hoping I'd get, I directed them to the website and the application and resume, and I haven't gotten anything back yet. And then
she
Roxanne,
said that she's like, definitely, she was sick.
Roxanne,
she said,
knows somebody.
Updating the resume.
Okay. So knows somebody that wants to apply also.
Did we post it at the school?
Two people.
Kate Lucas got a digital copy and a paper copy like 2 or 3 weeks ago. I dropped it off at the last school board meeting. It was the paper copy. And then 2 weeks ago, I was in Vermont because of family issues, and I sent her a digital copy of it. The Somersworth superintendent said it was okay. However, printer is out of ink, and I have not made it over there because I've had a backlog of things to do since I've gotten home. So they said, as long as I drop it off there, they'll get it out to the Somersworth schools. So.
The director said it's more to the teachers.
Yes. And I was thinking, since I'm going to Somersworth, and this will probably happen tomorrow, that I would drop it off also at the Department of Employment Services and see if they have anybody that's like losing their job for the summer, like a teacher that may be looking for part-time work or something.
Well, that might be a good idea for, I think, some of the South Burma got laid off.
And did you post the UNH for work study?
Yes, that's
got posted.
They were supposed to be doing that. posted also under the their employment office.
How many counselors were we looking for?
Looking for eight.
Eight, okay. I just didn't remember.
How many do we have? Five?
We have
three and a half.
Four.
Yeah.
Yeah, three and a half.
Isabel Savati, is she in
there? Yep, she's in there. Yeah, she's the one that won't be here till May 8th.
Oh, okay.
Kathy, looks like you're looking for a job, but I think the director position would be open for you.
Yeah.
I think so.
Well, I hear you have tons of free time.
Oh, I do. I was sleeping for it too, when I have to figure out most of the summer.
I talked to Kristen Burnett into it. I almost had her.
Reno and Kristen, mm-hmm. Yeah.
But then
I talked to him about his daughters, perhaps.
Yes, yes. I talked to Taylor about it also.
Yeah. Do you live right near them? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
And I also spoke to one of the parents whose daughter came highly recommended from Leicester last year, Daly Haynes. Mm-hmm. I talked to her dad.
Oh, she's a bad egg.
But she has a opportunity to do an internship this summer, which she was waiting to hear on last time I talked to him. So it looks like she's unavailable.
Yeah, I think she's
going to
St. Paul's, isn't she?
That's what I had heard,
yeah.
That she was waiting for her
good
confirmation
for her.
When town meeting occurred, because I strongly suggested to her parents that she would apply.
Mm-hmm.
So.
So when they apply through the Work Study Program, does it go to people who take care of the Work Study Program first? Is that how that works?
I could do that all.
Or does it come to us?
Okay. I just wasn't sure how that.
No, and you know what? I have two questions out there too. Because I had a girl that was interested who goes to UNH, and so you were CC'd on that email, weren't you, that I asked the woman who said you guys got the perp study, mm-hmm. and that I'm going to be away for like a week or something like mm-hmm. that, so I asked her, I have a UNH student, but she doesn't think that she is eligible for work study, you know, how does that work, like can she...
If we hired her, she wouldn't be part of the work study. If she already maxed out her work study.
Right.
Because they're only allowed so much per year.
That wouldn't affect her, that would just affect us.
That would, yeah, that doesn't affect her. We would still have to pay her our salary at full fee.
Right. So I should get and talk to her just to apply again. And I also asked them how many they approved for work study, and I didn't see anything back from her on that either.
When does their work study start, though? Like, if you're maxed out for this year, does it start again July 1st?
I don't know.
Because there's two cycles according to the paperwork, and you're only allowed so much per year. So there's a fall, and you have to specify why you need a summer work study. And we had to specify we could only use summer work study because our program is only in the summer. So I'm assuming it goes year to year, but they didn't say specify in the paperwork.
Because when I was in college, and I'm coming up on 15 years out, it's like we were given a chunk of sum throughout the year, and like you could use it in the fall or in the spring, and once you max it out.
Right, you probably already maxed it out.
So,
yeah. You sure when your age, like Mike did the other day when he said, put it on the cork board. Like, we don't do that anymore. I did talk to Kate, or I emailed Kate Lucas about the shed, because we weren't sure about the shed. And the maintenance man at the school could meet with somebody this Wednesday from 12:30 to any time between 12:30 and 2:30. Is anybody available? Wednesday.
To do, what are we doing there?
To go in the shed and, like, find out, like, what's in it.
So
which one's ours?
Well, I was going to say, so the school doesn't use that at all, or is that any?
I have no idea.
Oh, okay.
I emailed her and I said, wondering if you could meet with the maintenance facility about the shed, And
at what was the option of time?
Wednesday. his name is Dick, and Wednesday, anytime Wednesday between 12:30 and 2:30.
I could go over also at like I can't go until at least 1:00. So maybe I could go between 1:30 and 2:30.
Okay. I'll go over that to you and to them.
Okay.
So the one I was talking to you about, I think the pay is an issue. Like, it's not quite enough for her, the girl, for the director. So we can discuss that a little bit. That was the case for two people that I've spoken to that are both free this summer, but that wasn't. So they're gonna do other things. So I didn't know.
Well, you can always apply and ask for more if they.
I'm a tiny bit worried about the pay since it's such and such less than I make now, but I do want to see what it's about.
Well, and if we end up getting work study folks, then we have more money in our budget for salary to go in other places.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So.
When they know about the work study, I wonder if it's kind of weird.
I mean, if they're looking for $20 an hour, I don't see how that's going to happen. So, it really depends.
In your experience, too.
Right.
It's $13.75.
$13.75. I mean, there might be leeway in there for, I don't know, what would you say?
Yeah, we can go up to $13.76.
Yeah.
Let them know.
But yeah, we'd have to crunch some numbers and see how that goes with work study and stuff, but yeah.
I mean, push comes to shove, if we do not have a director and she's insisting on $14, you know, so be it.
Yeah, tell them to, mm-hmm. I mean, buy and talk and get things. See, it's negotiable up until a certain...
Do we have a resume?
Is this who she's talking about?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, that's right.
Did they not apply because they weren't?
I'm trying to figure that out.
Yeah, okay.
She just said she just wanted to see what it was all about.
Yeah, you want people experience too. So
right.
See.
Sure.
So as far as the work study is concerned, do we want to follow up with, I don't know what that woman's name.
I will do that this week, just because now I've been thinking about it. And so, I wonder if she's back in the office, right?
She should be by now, I think.
I also, while I'm thinking about emailing, I sent an email to Bridget about the slogan that Kristen, you know, promoted, and I haven't heard anything back from her about that, yes or no, or... So I sent that on Tuesday, so I haven't heard anything, so maybe I'll...
I have a question. This is more directed towards Jody. I saw you sent that email to Suzanne about we are basically capped at what our budget line is.
Mm-hmm.
And anything over that goes into the town funds.
Mm-hmm.
And then at the end of the year, the select board can decide to give it back to us or whatever. So if we raise money and say we have money in the budget to play with, could we use that money to raise the salary line?
No, you have a set line.
$39,997.
You would be over budget.
I wasn't here last time.
No, I'm saying, can we take from another line? I only watched the first 20 minutes.
Oh, I said that number a lot. I'm sorry.
Could we take from another line to cover?
What do you mean another line?
T-shirts. From t-shirts.
Yeah, you have 39, that's it.
Because we're not going to have to pay any for t-shirts, so we're
right.
Take money from the t-shirt line and put it into salaries.
Yeah. You rearrange your lines any way you
right.
see fit.
We've told them we're going to spend up to $39,97. So if we decided we want to spend all of that on salary, we could do that potentially, I guess. They might get mad at us because we told them we were going to spend it otherwise. But so as long, I mean, so I think...
Nope.
Realistically, as long as
you got to juggle the balls as they come, like you you plan a budget, but it doesn't always work out that way.
It never works out that way.
Right, exactly. So, you know, your furnace may break or your roof may go or whatever, but you juggle the balls where you may, and that's, if that's where you have to pull from, that's where you have to pull from.
So our bottom line has to remain the same.
Right.
But we can play with the individual lines within the budget.
Yeah.
So,
outside when we were talking, you said that it's room there, right?
We're talking about tuition assistance?
No.
Sorry.
If we do end up bringing in more dollars.
I was talking about tuition assistance.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Okay.
Because we, you and I talked to Carol and Suzanne about that.
Yeah, we had a meeting on Wednesday.
Yeah, so if we have people asking for tuition assistance and we receive donations that are more than what people are asking, and we can take that money and roll it, she said, roll it over to next year to make sure that stays for tuition assistance the next year.
Legally, no. What happens is that as you put money in, it's being taken out of your taxes. Does that make sense?
Well, I don't know the logistics of it. I just know that somehow, some way, we're going to be able to keep
if
that
it's,
money somehow.
If it's put towards a child, then obviously you're going to spend that money on the child first. Mm-hmm. So the money won't come out of, I don't know, football or basketball or whatever. But right now you don't have a revolving fund. So you can't say, okay, we took $240 for a child, but we didn't have a child to use it on. So we can't save it yet for the next year, for another child, legally.
So if I'm somebody writing a check, knowing that it's going towards
a child,
if I know it's just not going to be there for anybody, for any child, then I'm not so sure I'd want to write a check. See, does that make sense?
Yeah, but I don't think that's going to be an issue. I think we have plenty of people with...
But we already have people that have said, that have heard that around town, that said, look, I'm not sure if I want to donate now that I'm hearing that if this money might just go to the town and not to a kid.
Well, I can't imagine it not going to a child first. But you're right, but I understand both sides.
Okay. Yeah.
But what I'm telling you is legally it has to go back in the general fund if you don't use it.
That's
the legality.
So can we refund it to them if we don't? Can we say yes, we will put it towards a child? And if not, we'll refund it to them.
If you're under budget,
yeah.
That'd be a legality nightmare for Caroline, but yeah.
Well, I'm just thinking.
I'm just not worried about it.
Either.
I just think you're going to see
Caroline
with a 39,
that's what she's saying. Then
yeah.
You can't,
and
there's.
It was Gail that.
Yeah, I had talked to Gail about that too, yeah.
Just to rest them assured that, hey, I tell you what, if we don't have a kid that needs it, we'll give it back to you. Because they're saying.
Logistically, it would be an accounting nightmare, but. I really don't see an issue of children not needing it. I really don't.
I agree.
We already have two or three that have already emailed us. So
I'm seeing one.
How do they apply for help?
That was something I was going to ask you guys today. I asked the select board. The select board didn't care, and we'll officiate it tomorrow. That because we had it yesterday. For the police about how you guys wanted to verify that.
So we talked with her on Wednesday, and what we got coming out of it was to contact Kate Lucas. So we're going to vet these applications. So somebody
for assistance?
Yeah, somebody says, hey, you know, I would like my child to attend, can't afford it. So their response to us was contact Kate Lucas to find out if they're already receiving
lunch or something.
Yeah, and services.
Can she disclose that?
She can't disclose that.
Can she say, yeah, I think you should?
You're just a regular townsperson. You can't know that information. I mean that in the nicest way possible, but that's...
Yeah.
That's like the select board does not know who we're giving assistance to. They are a number. So they, like.
So how are we supposed to figure
that
out?
So that's just it. So one of us is going to have to.
Can we request it?
Well, how does the school figure out who's?
They fill out a form saying that they want reduced lunch and they have to verify your income. You can go by, there's different ways to verify it. We have a welfare form that people have to fill out. And we can verify that as a, do you want to go through the select board? If you go just by Medicaid, everybody can get Medicaid now, so you may have people that are in $300,000 homes that have Medicaid. Because every child is eligible for Medicaid. So that's not the best way. If the parent is on Medicaid, then that's a better way because they have to have $2,500 of assets or less. So, but then there's that line in between. So I like the idea of asking Kate, but I don't think she's allowed to disclose that information.
Could she say, like,
No.
That could just be.
No. I think it should go through us, or if it has to go through me, that's fine. But just let me know what your parameters are.
So
do you want last year's tax returns?
We just need to come up with some questions and.
Well, I don't
want to
do
it
either.
We probably find some website that has forms that we could use.
Yeah, like it's an easier form, maybe.
Well, we've been copying and stealing everything. So
right.
What does?
Well,
Barrington,
no, we have a town welfare form.
Yeah.
But what do the other?
I don't think
but
anybody else offers assistance.
Does the town welfare?
You can't afford it.
You
can't
know their financial information. But is there a spot on there to say?
I don't need
child care assistance.
Look in their booklet.
No,
I have it under my blue.
Okay. you're going too far here.
Well, I'm just thinking that when Caroline comes in and she does the welfare at your select board meetings, at the end of the private session, you come out and you say, we're giving $550 to this applicant for rent.
Right.
So I'm wondering if there's a box that could just be... I don't know if it's too difficult.
We wouldn't give for daycare.
For a child.
You don't get welfare for daycare. So, but all I need is income.
That's
and
a
income
good question, too. Are we
is income
buying
range.
Money for
so
free
you
and
just,
care?
You just need
no.
Any?
No, just regular camp.
You just need income range to determine. You just need
somebody
that has their income range to determine if they would be eligible for
right.
Assistance.
Right, and then, like, my work does... federal guidelines, if you fall within the federal guidelines of the poverty level.
Mm-hmm.
And if you want me to use that as a parameter, I'll use that. But they have to show either last year's tax returns or 4 weeks' pay stubs.
Yeah.
How's that?
So why don't we come up with something to propose here?
Yeah, I like the 4 week pay stubs because people that are newly divorced or something.
That's true. Yeah.
So last year's tax return and 4 pay stubs?
No, or. And I'll double check what the federal guidelines are for poverty level. My computer won't pull it up right now.
So I propose that I propose that Jody come up with a way to word this appropriately, and then I'll second it.
So Jody, in roles and responsibilities, we do have a gap there for tuition assistance.
Yep.
I'm going to take that gap.
Mm-hmm. I will take that gap.
You are the best.
Yay.
Thank you. Jody, what we do for work.
So. Do you want to go through that?
Awesome.
That list?
Oh, it's on the agenda.
I have it.
Did you get that?
Oh, yeah.
The roles and responsibilities list,
When did you email it?
When the agenda went out.
Wednesday night?
The first Sadie was the only one that we have in 2017 yet. Yeah. Okay, so Jody made a motion. Is that correct? Jody, did you make a motion?
Can I put that on my resume?
Let me What do you want on your resume?
CFO. Let me explain how this works first, and then you guys can decide what poverty level you want to bring it down to. If you are a 200% if you are at 200% poverty level and you are a family of four, you make your family makes less than $48,000 a year. Okay. If you are a family of seven and you make less than $73,000 a year, you are 200% below poverty line. So
that's impressive.
Massaging.
I get working.
So now, do you guys want to go with there's a 150%, a 200%, a 133%? So.
Do we wait and find out how many people apply and how much money we have?
Yeah, because we can actually give assistance if we don't have the donations, right? But we still need to talk about guidelines. Oops, sorry. Sorry, guys.
So do you want to do a 150?
So sorry.
150%, which is a family of four that makes less than $36,000 a year.
Look, here's what I would say, is if we have three people that apply,
mm-hmm.
and we have three people mm-hmm. that have donated,
okay.
and one of those peoples is at people is at 125 and the rest are at 150, are we going to say no to one even though we have money?
Okay, so we'll go with the highest, 200%.
Yes.
Okay, so we're going by the federal poverty guidelines of 200%. And they must show last year's tax returns or 4 weeks of income.
And
fair
then
enough?
And then it's based on first come, first serve. If you fall within that, it's first come, first serve.
And then that will also help our donors understand who they're helping.
Okay.
So
propose that.
Out of 11, we have 8. I'll make a motion to set our assistance guidelines to the 200% federal poverty level for the 2016 federal poverty level guidelines.
I second.
With showing last year's tax returns or 4 weeks' pay stubs.
Second.
I second.
Last year's accurate.
Can we co-sign?
Yes.
So all of it.
Tax returns or
quick question before I move on and we put a second on it. In-town residents only or all applicants?
Question.
I think we were going to go in-town first.
I thought in-town residents mm-hmm. only, my personal opinion.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I think so. We did two. And then Roxy and Sick.
She's like really.
So all in favor?
Aye.
Anybody opposed? Okay. Okay.
So anybody who get that, just send it to me and I'll.
Okay. So all emails about tuition assistance will Jody will handle.
Okay.
Which is great. She handled the first
one. So going back a little bit, we have. I tried to print. It came out blank. My list of donors that I currently know right now. There are three. Which one is four? One is requesting to remain anonymous, which they spoke to Jody at town meeting, and I have their name. It gets all of us by email. Waiting to hear back from them. I sent them an email. C&J has come in, and they're great. We have their check so far. And then the Ladies Guild from the church is the other one. And then
that's awesome.
The fourth one is the lady that lives down on the side.
Aikman,
yeah.
Who also
wanted
to remain anonymous?
So we have two that remain anonymous.
Yeah.
I have yet to contact the second. So, I don't know if this is next on the agenda. I can jump right into sponsorship if you want.
Yeah, it's fine.
So, I have a list of people that you think we should donate to. If you have any ideas.
Donate to?
Get donations from. So I put down like their company name and their contact information. So if you, like you had said, you had contacted a pool company.
Right.
That were still, and I didn't know if we wanted to contact them. And then this.
Well, and you weren't here, so yeah, we're kind of on the donations, right? I think we're all kind of.
No, we decided that we were going to do the, not
oh, the
poster,
banners.
The banner,
okay.
And hang that up, and so they weren't going to be on shirts,
right?
But we're going to pay buy the $80 banner or whatever.
Yep.
So if,
Cool Dad.
Very nice, thank you. Or, you know, anyone else that we've come up with or spoken to that hasn't gotten back to us,
yeah.
Or what have you, we'll just put them on that.
Are we still soliciting or trying to solicit more money? Because we had this conversation at our last meeting that technically we can't spend more than the...
89997.
I'm talking donation physical items versus money. Supplies donated.
So we can talk with Akapo about donating potentially a pool.
So
to my house.
Hey, I was waiting for her to say that.
Good idea.
But I was thinking, I have reached out to REF, which was going to be our grant of $1,000, and their grant was supposed to be the beginning of April, and nobody got back to me. And we did put into our budget up to
grant.
20.
That's true.
$2,500. So we have a donation right there for half of it, but we could endeavor to go another $1,250.
Okay.
To cover the grant line.
Right.
Since we have not applied for any grants, and that would remain in our budget.
Good thinking, Celia.
So you're looking for people who.
So that would give us that we don't go over our budget, and then. The other thing is if we don't get, right now we only have 18 campers signed up and registered. If we don't get the same level of campers we had last year that we projected we were going to have, we're going to have more room to expand our fundraising goals. If that makes sense.
18 campers are going to have an awesome campus.
So, I mean, if... And we can cover those that are asking for financial assistance.
Yes,
she's got it.
Oh, yeah, Jordan.
Oh, well, you
no,
said
no,
he's
no,
oh,
he's
you already asked him.
He gave
oh,
me
okay,
a thumbs up on that. So
okay,
I just have to follow up on that one. No,
so
I'm
put this together
there
for
yesterday.
Our kids.
Yeah, I know. So the bottom line is that we still will try to solicit 12 or 50 of these t-shirts.
And like,
right? And that's
that. We're going to try and say.
So
I want to say between $1,250 and $1,500 so that we can cover financial assistance. Because then the 15, because we know that we've already had one person come to us that wants to apply for financial assistance. And that would be one camper that we're picking, that somebody else is paying the fee for. Does that make sense?
Assuming they fall within our parameters.
Right.
What's the limit on?
I
think we discussed in the beginning 80.
Right.
So my question is, if we get 80, the bus is only holding.
No, the big bus holds how much?
75.
Yeah. No, 75 is a smaller one.
Oh, really?
I thought it was 95.
Okay, so the state parks, I've been telling them a lower number than if we get a full camp. So 40 to 60.
I said. So if we end up with 80, then is that a big deal, do you think? Should
I? I don't think they'd be like,
kids. They're not going to stop them. I would assume our first field trip might have a lower amount of kids, so I think we'll be good for the first.
Yeah, I just think you're just going to get flooded the last week because all of us parents forget.
Yeah. I haven't done mine yet.
Yeah, I counted
myself.
I forgot to cover April vacation, and it's what, next week or the week after?
I don't think we need to worry about the course right now. I really don't.
Here, can you?
Well, I know somebody that for the right price would cover it for you.
No, they're going to the works now.
Oh, okay.
So we've all agreed that we're still going to continue sponsorships.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Sam, I didn't.
So, Celia, that's okay. I will watch the video
like,
and catch up.
I'm like liking your pink shirt over there, though.
So this. This is what was, it's supposed to be blue. I told you my pink is running out.
I kind of like the pink. I thought it was a new style that we were going to offer.
So this is, I sent the letter that you guys updated and sent to me last week. This is the second page of it. Kristen did, because I just got a tour this weekend, did not have a chance to update the letter in the format that we were looking at, but this is the sponsorship levels. And the color's off, but that is what it would look
so
like.
So once we have that finalized and that's ready to go, what's your plan to get this out? How are you gonna do that?
I'm going to go to a bunch of businesses and talk to them, and contact them by email or phone or in person.
For money?
No, is so Roxanne and Kathy are on the.
Yeah, so they can.
What are we asking for? Supplies, money.
We're asking for supplies and money because somebody had suggested to me that we contact Wentworth Greenhouses, and although they are not usually very good about giving funds, they are very good about giving time and materials.
Mm-hmm.
So
for the bed that you're building,
right?
So that would go well with the garden.
You need a backup. My brother-in-law has one.
So I think it would be good to do ask for both a donation of goods and or money. And since we don't have the grant money coming in, and we have to cover scholarships for a couple of families, maybe we can say you can. That is just for money.
Okay.
But we could ask, you know, we could tell them you don't have to donate money, you could donate goods instead.
Okay.
That would go to 3997.
Yes.
And do we want, like, I don't think I'm clear about easy apps, or do we want something, do we want to talk to the school about having something more?
You can't have anything permanent because there, you run the risk of either the weather ruining it or vandals at night.
Okay.
They're
going
to have to take them down every night.
Every night. Okay.
And easy ups are like $100.
Mm-hmm.
Like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
$50.
And I would feel much better losing an easy up than $1,000 tent.
I agree.
Mm-hmm. So I did tell Kate Lucas that we have very lots of members on the committee that have relatives that are in construction. And if she needed anything built or repaired, let us know. So she will look around the school and see if the dugouts need sheds or shed roofing or something like that. So,
okay.
And then I'll put my brother work.
I just want to worry about that stuff. You know, if they send in a check without putting anything in the line.
Joe, the shed. How big is it and how much space did we have last year?
It's not that big.
Like
that one?
We had like a pool table and stuff in it, so it took like more.
Oh, you had a pool table in there?
Yeah.
And did that take up pretty much most of it?
Sort of?
So that gives you an idea. What are we doing?
I took it back.
I wrote 42 on that.
There's a one for the second T-shirt.
Oh, so, yes. As this is what I have right now for scholarships. Since the shirts are taken, there was discussion about putting things on banners, and that we cannot overspend our budget line, bottom line. So we should ask for goods instead. However, since we are not getting grants, we should continue to fundraise to cover our grant line. Up to $1,250 slash additional scholarship funds.
Can we post on Facebook that even people in town or whatever, you know, accepting donations for games and stuff like that?
Well, you posted about the easy ups.
Okay.
We did that, but yeah, definitely.
Do you want to do that one, Dale?
Sure.
I'm just thinking sometimes people have like a air hockey table that is just in the way.
Yeah, yep.
You have an
one in my house.
Would the kids kill you? If
Well, they won't know. Well, is it working? Is
the Did you have a four-wheeler too?
Yeah, we had a four-wheeler.
I don't know. That
would be great. Golf cart. A golf cart.
You have a golf cart too? The other end is
some stuff? Uh-huh.
Golf cart people.
Once we have the list, I was thinking that. We could meet, but the three of us go over the flyer and talk to the businesses on the list.
Where's the business?
Oh, yeah.
Does that take 7 hours?
We still call it friendlies at our house.
Yeah, inter.
I sign up for Olympics. I'm gonna go to friendlies.
May I ask us to write down people that we think might?
Does that make it
more people
to talk
to? Oh, Joe, do you know the name of the market?
Oh, interstate.
Yes.
Is it
Borderline? Oh,
Borderline.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe if maybe we can work something out with him for pizzas.
Mikey's wicked good. It's closed, but the guy who made pizzas there
is over there.
Pizza there.
I mean, they were going
yeah.
to Little Caesars, which is pretty dirt cheap.
It's
But if he
sometimes they when the softball league orders pizza, we have a set thing. We're going to order 3 pizzas every night, and they give us that $5 rate, and then they deliver. And so we just cut them a check or whatever at the beginning of the year, and it's a done deal.
Yeah, I think their problem was, at least I know how they did it last year, was they would, all right, who wants a slice in the morning, and then they would, so they wouldn't do a, this. I mean, I'm sure if they just made sure they didn't over-order, they'd be fine.
That's hard, yeah.
And I know, like the booster clubs, I was visiting my parents, I was talking with the parents up there, of the boosters up there, and every Thursday night during basketball season, they order game pizzas for the boosters. And they order 8 pizzas from, and like every third or fourth week, the pizza place donates them, so that the booster gets to keep the money they bring in. And then they just find sponsors to buy the pizzas the other week. So then,
so, but that's a conversation we can have with him. Is maybe he doesn't necessarily want to make the money, but he'll give us the pizzas at cost or whatever. And then he can have his name on the banner too.
Yeah.
So we're going to call them.
Borderline
slash state line.
I was just telling Kathy that. Once we get the list together, yeah. The three of us will set up a time to meet and divide and conquer, or go together and talk to the businesses. And
as far as the field trips go, did you get my email about the extended school program? Is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesdays from 8 to 1 on July 10th through August 9th. So I don't know if that has anything to do with field trips.
What is that?
What is that?
It's like special ed. that happens at
the school. Okay,
they call it extended school program.
Okay,
for the summer.
And what is it?
It goes July 10th to August 9th, and it goes from 8 to 1, Monday, Tuesdays, and Wednesdays.
Are we not supposed to be there?
No, that was just, we were planning trips, and
so
we were like, the kids in camp.
If the kid's in camp, they're going to miss the trip on Tuesday.
But, I mean, I don't believe that those,
which
every kid goes all 3 days. Correct me if I'm wrong.
I don't know, I think it depends on the kid and their plan.
Yeah, it's really too much to travel.
And it's 3 days, not like it's just one where we could just not, it's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
Right.
And we're not going to do field trips Thursdays and Fridays, that's just...
They'll get the Friday one.
Yeah.
I think that the student does go all 3 days.
Well, that's up to the parent, if they want them to go on the field trip or to do their schooling.
Right.
That's not up
to us. I'm not sure it's anything we need to...
Yeah, that's not our issue.
Yeah.
And we have a stay back option anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Right.
So the kid will do their schooling and have the stay back. If the parent chooses, or they miss the Tuesday schooling and go on the field trip.
What did they do last year?
That's not our fault.
Jordan, what did you last year for that? Was there any...
We didn't have field trips on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. We just have
Thursdays, right? Yeah.
Okay.
I just had a personal experience with that because my son, you know, this is going back, had to go for
3 days.
Mm-hmm. And one of the counselors said, "Why do you have to do that? Are you stupid?"
We will address that.
And I spoke to the director about that, and nothing was done. So I just hate that.
It won't happen. I will do my darndest to make sure that does not happen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's really disappointing.
Mm-hmm. I won't go on, but it was. But
I don't think, because it's 3 days, I don't think we could move field trips and do them back to back.
Well, and if there was, the kids will have the opportunity to go to the pool on Fridays.
Yeah.
Right. And since it's July 10th to August 9th, the program goes...
And they'll have a couple days.
Yeah, they'll have a couple.
The end of the year and the beginning of the year, mm-hmm. they can still do.
It'd be more like incentive for them to get all their work done if they could take off that weekend and go away, right?
I don't know how it works.
If
it's like school where you have to go every day, or if it just depends on if you get work.
Usually, you know, they want you to go every day, and the bus this evening, the bus that comes around to your house and picks them up and drops them off.
Yeah, okay.
Well, there's a bus that comes too. I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm. So, I'm just going to, we're just looking at this. I'm going to make sure that.
So, the extended school program goes from July 10th to August 9th, from 8 to 1. And there's a possibility we will lose campers for this event. And last year it was an issue because field trips were on a different day. This may influence the stay back program, and it's a decision for the families to make what their child is doing.
Celia, are we all set with sponsorship donations?
Yeah.
As far as discussion?
Yep.
Okay.
So that's the levels right now, as they were sent to me last time. And then just to reiterate, the check for the t-shirts has come in, and then I'm waiting to hear from to a pre-order.
Okay.
The
and
check
they
for the t-shirts?
So
the main thing that we talked about was trying to get it so we don't have an email coming from yourself, and then you, and then you, and you, and me not knowing if they're duplicate people, if you then pass it to Dan, who then tells me again, and so we got to come up with a process to make sure that I'm getting communicated only once about income. And so what we...
So, with the roles and responsibilities list, so whoever has that bucket is solely the one person responsible for funneling that information to Lester, if it's money related. So, for example, I get the registrations in, and I know how much money is coming in, so I give that information to Lester. I'm the only one giving that information. T-shirts, if you get any t-shirt money, or anything like, or donations, you funnel that through Lester, and that's it. So that's...
Donations, registration...
There will be concessions from your...
Concessions from the director, I assume that's who we're going to give that
to.
So those are the only three people, and once you send me notification, I'll respond to you and say, got it, or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But then that's been recorded.
And that's it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that'll resolve that issue.
Mm-hmm.
And because the other issue that I have is I have just some of the donations last week that we talked about were just lump sums, and then I wasn't quite sure if we duplicated them again when I got another email. So I have a total of donations. $145.23, and how that breaks down is I have way too many tabs. That's how it breaks down. So we had $38 at the town hall, $4.23 from the town hall coffee, $41 from the pizza, and then I had $62 other.
Mm-hmm.
Is that accurate?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so then I didn't get anything duplicated there.
As far as I'm concerned, that's accurate.
So you had town hall on meeting day, or
mm-hmm.
voting day.
Mm-hmm. For 38.
And then pizza for 41.
41.
And then coffee for 420.
23.
23.
And then we had $62 in additional donation.
That was town meeting.
What was that town
meeting? Oh, that was town meeting.
Yeah.
Okay. So then town meeting, we got $38 at one point and $62 at another point and $41 at another point.
Mm-hmm.
So,
well, no, the $38 was on Thursday. And everything else was on Saturday.
That's
town voting.
Yep. Okay, gotcha.
The other one was a town meeting day.
And
that Saturday.
Yeah. So the 423 was the leftover money that you didn't take.
Mm-hmm.
That I slotted.
Yep. And Caroline has receipts for all of that that you just spoke of.
Okay.
Left in the
envelope.
Yeah, I've already seen it. Well, if I have a check mark with my initials on the corner of it, that means I've seen it.
Okay.
So, good. Then I think
no.
All the numbers are accurate then.
Yeah.
So then at this point, the only expenditure that we have is $235 for the buses. That's the only thing that we've cut.
Well, that's for the park.
That's what I meant. and then we got $14.27.23, not including this, which I'll put in there now, because this is a fundraiser, and you've notified me of it.
Yeah.
There you go.
All right. So
you have a copy.
How much?
Mm-hmm. Do you need a copy of this, or do you want it for any reason? It's a copy of the purchase order.
I have the purchase order number.
Yeah.
So
you
as long as I have the number and the amount, then I'm fine.
No, I do not need that one. But how much did you say we have in for fundraising?
Hold on, I'm gonna add C&J.
Oh, ninth.
All right, so that brings us to, so we're at a total of 26,77,23 with 13,95,23 in donations.
I'm going to wait into your personal space.
26,95, you said?
26,77,23. So right now we're in the black.
It's the only part of town that is.
Don't be thinking about taking our money. We're not over it.
So your fundraiser, what does that include?
The fundraiser includes the money from town voting, money from the coffee, the money from pizza sales, and the town meeting, and the C&J.
So all the money from that plus C&J. So you have a separate sheet that you're just doing t-shirts on?
I got a sheet for
that, yeah.
Each
okay.
thing.
He's got tabs.
I got tabs, toilet paper, everything.
You're dying.
No, but donations of sunscreen and baby wipes are going to be needed.
So that's where I'm at. So as long as we're good with you two and whoever our director is, and I'll just respond back with, got it, then we're good. And then, you know, any POs or expenditures, which I guess will primarily be from you guys or
yeah.
the director.
Mm-hmm.
Can you push this cold coffee me so
I don't know if there's a cold coffee,
but I'm
sorry.
It's too late to joke
with
me.
I'm like, what?
I'm like,
what?
Right? I'm like, he's kidding, right?
I'm like... She just wants to know, so when she gets to a meeting, she's not completely flustered. What's this?
I just did that.
How much
is,
do they have?
I don't know.
So when you guys copy me, or you send me a note,
yeah.
Go copy.
Yeah.
Go copy. Got it. Thank you.
So.
For sure.
Okay. And I will not respond. Because then that just creates the
yes,
email.
Yes, that will create.
I don't
want to
do that.
Send.
So.
There
we go. You
can blind CC me. How's that? No, I don't care.
So did you finish talking about
the
whole pool payment thing?
The
pool?
We,
oh.
Oh. We can just give you, I can give you an update on that, and you might be able to finish the sentence. But so I contacted the pool director, because we talked about how to pay the pool.
Oh, yeah.
And he said that what they would do for us is, basically, we could pay them the following week for the previous session. So we'll be a week behind. So as we go through, he'll tell us when we leave or hand whoever's probably the director that's there that you had, you know, 52 swimmers today.
Yep.
And so then we just need to cut the check and bring it with us the following week.
Yep.
The director will probably know when they get on the bus. I got 52 swimmers.
Right.
Yeah, the only thing with Caroline is that she needs something in writing, whether it
right.
be from us or but something with a who has
that
the
pool
to signature.
2 weeks.
Well, if they go swimming on
Friday,
Caroline won't know till Monday.
Check.
Checks get cut on Wednesday or Thursday every other week.
Oh, really?
Oh.
She was telling me she cuts her checks on Mondays.
Well, that's even worse, though.
So,
but they have to go through the select board. They have to go to the select board. We signed the checks
so
on Monday nights.
So, yeah, we had this conversation with Caroline, and what she is going to do is if we can
and
get
she's
this.
And she's okay with that?
Yeah, she was actually
she can,
her idea.
She can make that work in a week?
She said this was her idea.
Great.
It's definitely her idea.
So we just,
because honestly, if I talked to Mick, I'm sure they would be fine with us being 2 weeks behind, you know.
Okay.
That we need to do that.
So we'll
they're,
just have a purchase order
yeah,
every week for
so
Monday.
Flexible.
She
on
just,
Monday night.
She didn't even mention purchase order.
Well, we have to.
She, I think, said she was going to bypass it based on the number of kids and the cost.
Yeah, actually, she did say that. She's gonna bypass purchasing.
I missed that part of the school.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Well, that won't be bypassed. There'll be some sort of record.
Well, that's what I'm trying to say.
But I will work out with Caroline what that will be.
No, well, I think I've already got it worked out.
Yeah, it was.
So she has to have some record, of course, and what we're going to provide Karen on Monday is whether it be we come up with a template or whether the folks at the pool write a letter. Either way, she has to have a piece of paper that says, this is how many kids attended that
yeah.
day, how much it costs per child, and
yeah.
have the pool.
Yeah, it'll be an invoice.
Pool guy sign.
The pool guy will sign,
yeah.
and
yeah.
we can get this to her on Monday,
yeah.
and she will cut a check and have the select board sign it Monday night.
Right, and then we'll
yeah.
sign the purchase order with it that night.
Okay.
Yes.
That's,
yes.
If you want to work out purchase order with her, that's
yes.
fine.
Yes.
That's,
we just need an invoice, purchase order, signatures. We're good.
All right,
perfect.
She'll do that Monday for us. Awesome.
Mm-hmm.
All right, there you go. There's the
question.
Situation.
So everybody that walks through the door at the pool, you're paying for, right?
I don't know if they charge, like, counselors.
You said they didn't charge
the counselors.
I don't think they do.
Okay.
I think it's just the kids.
So just the kids going in. And what happens if there's a kid that just decides not to swim that day and hangs out?
I think
charge.
That's his problem.
We still
charge,
yeah. They can't
yeah.
watch all the kids and see if they put their foot in the water.
Right.
You're wet.
Send
from
today.
I should confirm that, though. Let me write that down.
I mean, when my family goes swimming, if I don't go in the water, I walk in the door, I still have to pay.
Yeah. Let me make sure that we don't have to pay for counselors. That's it. That's an expense.
Yeah,
that we're writing up that.
Kelly, it's going on the to-do list.
Yeah. Are you writing me a to-do list?
I am.
I love that.
Throws the pen.
All right.
Then.
I like when she sends me my to-do list.
Can you make me one too?
I was gonna say, don't say that too loud.
Can you send one to my husband? Maybe he'll listen to your to-do list. All right, what's our next thing?
We need to add snacks to the budget for these meetings.
Oh.
Interesting.
Snacks?
If I don't get them on Monday night, you'll get them on Sunday night.
Well, you guys need to solicit them.
There we go. Donations.
Oh, snacks.
What we can talk about is the roles and responsibilities. If you guys
yeah, let's talk about that.
Yes.
We can get that wrapped up.
I'm really physically looking for folks to fill the gaps out there. Debbie was kind enough to take on the assistance, which is great. Did anybody have a chance to look at
I'll
it?
Look at them. You can put my name down for the first aid kits because I get lifeguarding, like.
So you'll
okay. magazine or something, and I can let you know.
So it's miscellaneous campus.
Yep. I saw the first aid kit.
Okay.
I would do the sport inventory coordinator.
So when Kelly goes on Wednesday, she can let you know what's on the inventory.
I'll forward that information to you, Dan. And you know what else?
And Dan, there's still
there's stuff
upstairs,
upstairs
right.
that we should.
Now, we were talking about, you know, I will make a post to Facebook about donations. Could I say they could bring them to
yep.
town hall?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, upstairs in the attic, there's like four.
Yeah.
So
Kate knows to leave it on my desk and
go from
there.
So I could just say, you know, if you have anything you'd like to donate, you know, I mean, within reason, puzzles with different pieces. And,
but like that's why we should go through because like even lawn like you know horseshoes and
lawn darts
croquet
yeah
badminton my kids love badminton
they play a lot of badminton too. We did a badminton
yeah I love badminton
2 months.
But I definitely want us to have a volleyball.
Kathy is signing up for the camp activity coordinator.
Okay.
What is Kathy signing up for?
Camp activity coordinator.
But I can help her. Like,
I'll be around if you need assistance, but I'm not going to be here the whole summer. That's
okay.
my problem.
Okay. So a lot of this, the director and assistant director will take care of.
Right,
right?
And I'll just help them with ideas. And
well, yeah, and it, so we got to figure out how we're going to, if they have these activities that we need to come to, we need to aid them. Okay.
And that is back, which, of course, is another note to let Lester know if anything.
Celia, you had a contact with a Doodlebugs person. Did she tell you about the master visit?
The Doodlebugs lady, she can come in and do like a class for $5 per kid.
Oh, okay.
Or
a class.
Yeah. A couple of hours. And she does programs through the Dover schools and the Kid Rec Department, and she just got into doing one for a rehab facility for the elderly. And those are like 4 to 6 weeks, and those run anywhere between $60 and I think $90. But it's like per student, but some of it pays the facility fees and stuff. And some of it's like, the 6 week one is you make a clay pot, then you paint it after she's fired it, you make a glass nightlight or pendant, and then she comes back another week and you do a guided paint on a piece of ceramic, like a tile or a mug, and then she comes back another week with that, and then 1 week is making another glass piece. So she splits it up between glass and ceramics, mm-hmm. and so she has 5 or 6 different things that she does.
I'm sorry, that's all grant related?
That's what Doodlebugs offers, but if we get funds and we want to bring her in.
Okay. We probably want to give Kathy all information. She can probably follow up where we left off.
Mm-hmm. But
I like that idea.
That's cute.
Yeah.
That's a great idea.
And I was thinking, talking about the funds, if we don't get the grant money, but we can fundraise that money, there's also a bunch of information that we talk about that's on the website for bringing in, like, wildlife encounters and what was the other one?
I think that's great.
Seaco Science Center travels to you and could come on our schedule.
Do you know the charges for that?
It's on the drive already.
Mm-hmm. Right, so if we still get people who want to donate $250 like the bigger businesses, then that'd be great. And it says that right on there.
Yep.
Yeah, I mean, that's great.
So then that would bring in like that, and that would be like something that could happen on a Wednesday or something.
Yeah.
And then there's also... And then there's also one in...
And then we have, I'll talk to you about that after Kathy will use set times for things like that.
Okay.
Sorry.
Well, but if we have someone that they have an opening on Thursday and we don't have it set up,
For sure. But yeah, and then there's also one out of Kittery too, or Kibnetic, that would travel to us.
Is this our exact thing?
We'll try to keep to that. I mean, we just need a guideline to go by, you know, like a good talking point to start with.
Right.
I loved it.
I just wonder how much that cost to print, because I got to put that in here.
The ink. I'm
going
to take
the lead.
That's
my
parenthesis. <for this piece. laughs>
So I'll put that under donations.
Where are you at?
On-site inspection. I mean, I'm around a lot in the summer, you know.
Okay.
So I was thinking, I mean, I can definitely make be heading up there. Or I exactly didn't know what you had in mind on that. But
so it was important in the very beginning when we started all this that the select board, they had talked about on-site inspections.
Yep. By this board?
By the select board. Now, we'd have to go back to them. Well, Jody, we're talking about on-site inspections, so Dan is offering to take care of the on-site inspection coordinator.
That'd be great.
Meaning we need to...
That'd be great.
How often would the select board want to do an on-site inspection? We can coordinate those things.
From the select board wants to actually do the inspection.
Well, it's just, you know, like walking around, see how things are going.
Yeah, any of us can do that, as long as we're reporting back to us, because... Like I said, everything that we're doing is such an improvement that, you know, I'm going to be there every morning and every night anyway. If someone can go and
you know,
I spent a little bit of time.
I'm around.
You think about staff, and staff needs to know that you're part of the rec committee. Just send the board an email and say, hey, I was there today, I'm part of the rec committee, things looked great.
So we can all just go whenever.
Well, we can come up with.
Yeah.
If you guys can't be around for a week, or if there's anybody who says, Dean, can you stop on Wednesday, or something like that?
They all have all city approval.
As a parent, if you just kind of walk in and you're kind of feeling.
Yeah, I mean, we would need to be, well, not for that, but like if we were to volunteer to say go on to the state parks, like we would need to be fingerprinted, we talked about that, right?
Right, was he going to talk about that?
Actually, I wanted to double check with that, because a parent asked me, they wanted to go on the trips as an extra supervisor as well, and I'm like, oh, wait, did that need a background check? Yes, it would.
Yeah, so that would be the other thing, if I wanted to come and check, I would probably.
Unless they drove themselves to the state park and paid to go.
And just happened to be there and happened to watch kids, that's kidding me.
But Jody, I have a question, maybe you can bring back to them on Monday, tomorrow. So I'm not background checked, but if I'm part of the rec committee and I want to go do an onsite inspection, just kind of like walk around for a little while, make sure everybody's okay and whatever, do I need to be background checked for that?
That is a very good question, I will bring you back to that.
But I don't have to be background checked to drop off my kid there.
But you're a parent at that point.
Right, but you have the same access.
But we are part of a committee that's overseeing a camp that has to do with children, so do we need to be.
Aren't we already, I mean,
you're not.
A ton of field trips with the kids.
What does it cost to do a background check?
$50.
So we're talking about another $500.
Yeah.
Right.
That's pretty expensive.
So that was my concern, you know, do we have to.
I have a double check.
Happening to show up at the field trips, is that. They don't have to supervise, what if the parent wants to go along with their child?
You don't have one of us go and.
And I went to the water country, but.
I mean, we can't stop a parent from showing up at the state park, but.
Well, they can't be responsible for any other kids.
Yeah, you can't give them a group of kids and you can't let them go home with them unless they're on the sheet that we have, because if mom and dad are divorced, or dad and Lita doesn't have custody, or mom, you know, so
I don't think that's.
You could tell these parents if they wanted to go, then you have to.
That's the look that I have, I'm thinking.
Like on the trip.
Or just in any of them, you know, but I'm sure some parents probably, if they really wanted to go, then they'd probably pay that.
Follow guidelines of the school, I'm sure the school has guidelines, right, if you go on a field trip with the kids.
Right, so who's covering that cost?
I don't know.
Because I didn't pay either. Somebody's picking up that cost.
Yeah, right.
Because I've been fingerprinted for the school.
Yeah, I had to go to the district.
Yeah, I can.
And get fingerprinted, I don't know what it was for.
Oh, yeah, I went to.
Oh, no, that was that one night, never mind, wasn't district.
School related.
I didn't know, I have to coach basketball.
That's okay. Roxanne put her name down on my sheet.
You know what I did at Fort Kelly, when I was gonna coach at RGS, even though they didn't say I needed to be fingerprinted, I suggested it and I went to the school.
I know, Roxanne signed up on my sheet.
Well, they didn't require it, but I just said, you know what?
But you didn't pay then, right?
No, I just.
The school is, I don't know.
Maybe they put, because obviously it's not through the school, but maybe they, that was when it was, who is this under kind of thing?
Right.
So they might have just said.
I'm gonna be second.
Maybe something like for next year, you might want to work the budget, you know, fingerprint.
I'm gonna let her do most of it.
Well, because we have in the budget, like, for what we have for fingerprinting.
Yeah. Does that make sense?
Yeah, Chris.
Yeah. Dee, what is our budget for fingerprinting this year, what line, how many?
Well, let me tell you, $624.
That's really weird.
We did $52 per 12 staff.
Okay, so we really just went 12 staff, okay, bare bones on that one. Did they say they were gonna charge, the police would charge us for that, yes?
What?
Fingerprinting for all of our staff, counselors.
I believe so.
That's just the income, right?
I don't remember him saying no, I thought I'll see him tomorrow morning.
I just need to add that column.
That's fine. I just figured it'd be your staff.
Somebody else pick up the, who picked, actually, maybe you can ask him who picks up the information at school. Where does that go? Because I know.
I'm assuming the school does that.
Yeah.
Yeah, but then we have grants.
I don't.
Which I guess are calling.
Yeah.
I don't look at their budget, so.
We have a community talent and demo coordinator. Who's not here?
Who can we assign?
Talent?
Okay, well, I have a sheet. I was just debating.
Don't overdedicate yourself.
Well, that's what I was thinking.
What is it, demo coordinator?
I was thinking.
Who made these up?
It would be the director.
But in the meantime, until we get a director, we write a couple emails, we want to coordinate some stuff. I mean, coordinate some folks.
I'll take myself to the staff orientation and training coordinator, which is just scheduling orientation.
Well, now we have manuals too, remember, we have staff manuals. So we want to be able to, I mean, I can certainly help you with the manuals, but I think you might want to partner up with somebody.
You need to make.
That's a big one.
We have to follow the town one, and then we can make it more stringent based on the town.
Do we have a copy of that one for the town?
I don't know if we have.
The town one.
We have to follow the town policies and procedures, and then we can make it more stringent. Do we
can't have a Camp Raleigh, we'd have to have a Camp Raleigh sort of specific manual. And I know Barrington has one, I would just need to.
Steal it.
I haven't looked at it yet. I haven't looked at it.
Yeah, we've done that.
So it would need to go to whoever wants to do that and to take it and make it a Camp Raleigh.
Well, I was thinking the t-shirts and the donor list are going to be done at the beginning of June. So.
But you do the minutes.
Yeah. So I guess I'd be willing to help on it, but maybe not do the whole thing. If that makes sense. Because. I don't want
to. Thing,
what is that? You would be a backup. Basically.
Yeah, I'm willing to assist there.
So
maybe
what is it? It's a staff orientation. You might be able to help, Jody. It's like setting up the training and the stuff like that.
Well, I'll be setting up the training for the CPR and stuff.
Right.
So I'm already doing that, but the staff orientation would be. Once again, the director, but we just have to set the days aside.
Is the director's salary position at hourly?
So,
didn't we set that as hourly instead of stipend? How did we set that up?
I don't know.
Well, and I'm not trying to throw a monkey wrench into this, but if these are things that need to be done and we're planning on tasking to the director, and they need to be set up and coordinated before we start, then we also have to be thinking about it's going to be more money for the director because there's 20 or 40 hours of work.
That's our budget.
Yeah.
Did we calculate that into the budget?
Because
we calculated for the time where we
calculated
had
for two
pre-training days.
We went with training and orientations $590. That was 6 hours per day for one day.
Right, and then we took the July 3rd.
So now we're looking at giving the directors, I'm just going to put a number on it and say 20 hours worth of work of setting stuff up before camp gets going that we're going to have to pay them for that isn't in our budget.
Well, which is kind of, yeah. Yes.
Okay. Just clarifying that.
That's true.
Or.
But the more work we do, the less we have. Not that we all have capacity, but.
I don't know. I almost kind of look at that. We can use Dan as our teacher. Like that, I mean.
Mm-hmm. So we get 2 days of work out of them because we are paying them for the third and the fourth.
So he has to prep for those 2 days. Does that mean we pay them? Exactly.
Well, I understand, but that's separate. I mean, you can't ask an employee to do work
and
not pay them.
I wish I was hourly.
That's why I was asking if the salary or hourly.
Yeah.
Well, how they've done it in the past, I know, is I believe the director and assistant director were salary and the counselors were hourly, I believe.
That's the way we did it.
So now.
But it's on the thing as hourly.
But the last day of school is just the 23rd.
No, it's the, oh, it's the 22nd actually.
So I believe we'll have to put that.
So the last day is the 22nd?
Yes.
So the only days we'll be able to get into school is the Friday, the 23rd, to set up.
Yeah.
I think I have that on the list here.
Okay, let's take that day off.
How about Saturday as well?
No, because then we have to pay someone from the school to be there for us to be able to set up. Because you can't have access to the school unless there's a school employee on premises.
Or you pay $60 a day for them to come in. I was just there today, paid $60.
Speaking of which, that was a question I asked Kate. Did we ever get a response to that, do you know?
You have to pay the janitor $60.
Did we ask her?
Or our teacher.
Well, when we want to get in and leave, how does that work?
Oh.
I think I sent her that note, she never replied.
Oh, yeah.
Who's got the facility? Who's our facility coordinator? So I had asked Kate what happens, you know, with that said, what happens if we, you know, we want to get there at 8, start camp at 8, and end at 5, so does somebody need to let us in? Somebody need to let us
in? Yeah.
How is that
working? Is that what I need to
say? So I asked Kate that 2 weeks ago, maybe even 3 weeks now, and honestly, I lost track of it.
I'm going in there.
So my bad, but you could talk to us. If you want to ask her that, that would be great.
Lets us in and locks us out kind of thing?
Well,
or does the director have a pass?
I have a fob to the school because I have an agreement with them for basketball, and they have my insurance and everything, and then, so I'm sure our director will get a fob. Now, there has to be an employee somewhere in the building, but they don't have to let me in. I can come in and open and close the door on my own.
From what I understand, from our original talks with Kate, is that there doesn't have to be somebody there the entire time that we're there. That's why she's given us that window.
Well, that's what she said. I'm just concerned that, because some things have changed. Some things have been deviated from since we first started talking about this. So I just want to make sure that that's not one of them. Yeah, you know.
That's contrary because she's had sent me emails and said, hey, what time are you going to be leaving tonight because the janitor wants to know because he wants to leave, you know, blah, blah, blah. So
I can tell you very vividly that they heard saying that there might not be anybody there after 3 o'clock.
Which maybe it's because the school's closed. I don't know.
Yeah, that's interesting.
All right, so what about, if we can just get back to this, what about talent and demo coordinator, which means just sort of where we get those emails for folks or calls or whatever that they want to volunteer their time? Spearheading that. We don't have to
call.
We still have people that are calling.
Calling people asking for them to donate their
time?
No. So we had some people come to us and say, well, I'll donate my time. Or we get an email, I'll donate my time, which is great. Just somebody who can keep those people.
Photoshop them like basket weaving or whatever their art.
What day?
Yeah, like Kate Haskins said she could do like a sea glass sort of demo, which is, you know, it's great, it's fun.
But who was reaching out, who was assigned to reach? Didn't we just send someone to reach out to Doodlebugs and stuff like that?
That's the two of us.
Okay, so then would they also just keep that on file?
They could, yeah.
Because they're not even reaching, they're just saying, thank you, we'll coordinate this and get with you, I appreciate it.
Yeah, make sure it gets in the, work with the director, make sure it gets in the schedule, and they know that you're on. So do you want to double up on that too?
Yeah.
So that would be a Kathy and Celia set.
Because if you guys reached out and totally booked the summer, you don't want Dan reaching out to these people saying, great, I'll get you booked.
So then take me off of the off the staff orientation training.
Absolutely not. All right, so I'll try and maybe Blake will help with that. Maybe Blake will be on. Transportation, I can actually do that because I already know Lisa from First Student, so I can contact her a little bit.
Who else is on our committee?
His wife is. And then there's Shana. who?
Yeah,
no, wait, she's an alternate, right?
She's an alternate.
And there's one other person, right? No?
I think I had something on me.
I thought there was a guy.
He came one time.
Jared. He never came back.
I know, we made a bad impression.
How many are there, I think?
It was.
Is that all we have?
You said 11.
I thought it was 11.
I thought it was 11.
There were two here, so.
There's nine and two.
Oh, Denise, who doesn't come anymore? So that's 10.
She's an alternate.
Nine members.
Shayna.
Nine members, okay.
All right, let's go with Shayna.
Is it Shawna or Shayna?
I work.
Shawna, quorum, yeah.
Oh, yeah, we're good.
We got it.
I had a question about the newspaper. They had another one, another page in the newspaper about summer camps. Do you want me to call or somebody want to call?
No, it's expensive.
Yeah, it's really expensive to do that.
Is it?
It's like hundreds of dollars.
Broke.
It's in color.
What about that parenting magazine?
I think it should be free.
They're gonna charge you.
We can't afford Tom.
We can't afford.
That's pink.
I was getting it, that was just stupid.
I would not recommend it.
I'm good. Well, just going here.
Tomorrow in Boston.
You can tell me.
I'm in Boston right now.
Oh, beautiful then.
Can't
meet. I don't know what paper was.
Okay, so the only thing we need to fill now is staff orientation and training. And maybe I can ask Blythe.
Well, I'm gonna be doing the, working with the fire department for your CPR training and your first aids.
Okay.
And then your staff training is going to, obviously going to be the first couple of days before they start.
Right.
22nd, 23rd, whatever.
Well, it's going to be something important, yeah.
Well, don't we talk to the fire department and find out from them? I mean, they might do it at the fire department.
No. The training for the CPR and stuff, yes, that would be the fire department.
And not staff training.
The scheduled days for that. But for the actual orientation for the staff to do their team building is gonna have to be someplace other than the school on the Wednesday and Thursday before, unless they do Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Yeah, that sounds good.
On one day, training, right?
Well, they're a fun weekend.
One day, 6 hours. Yeah.
And many of the kids show up and they are all cranky.
Right, exactly. But if they do need staff building, at least a couple of hours of it, so.
Well, setting up on, anyway, on Friday.
That sounds like a good staff building activity.
Setting up.
Setting up, yeah.
Thank you, Jim.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Sorry, guys.
Not on the weekends, but.
But in the week.
Yeah. If we set aside this room for during the week, that's Wednesday and Thursday during the day. Wednesday we're near 9 to 1, Thursdays are 3 to 7. So, and unless there's like a budget meeting or a historical meeting or whatever on those days.
Who's doing the training?
Good question. Should it be the director?
But again, I hate to be.
But they're gonna be new too, they don't have a clue.
Go ahead, Sally.
Debbie Downer, thank you.
Well, we would like to think that they have experience with this type of thing.
But now we're gonna have to, compensate them for, I don't know, 8 hours before that to come up with the days with the training and what they're gonna do. I don't know, 8 hours, I'm picking that number. So that's just more salary that we're gonna have to come up with.
Well, if they do anything for us, it wouldn't be on 2 days.
Exactly.
That's prep.
Which we gotta pay for.
So anything above and beyond 2 days, 16 hours, we need to pay them for. Unless.
We'll take that out of Jordan's pay.
I think it's possible that they can be qualified and have experience, so. When me and a bunch of BHP started at Trade, they just tossed us in there, like, you know, I'm qualified to do this job, but I wouldn't know how to train a bunch of people on what they're supposed to do in that sort of, you know, I think it's gonna be more hands-on, don't you think?
You mean as far as the directors?
Training the counselors and stuff.
Oh, counselors.
Well, what exact training are we expecting them to provide?
That's what I mean, because they're gonna be new as well, two rounds for two of these kids.
And we had discussed that there would be something about they're not allowed to have their cell phones, and who's going to be?
So that would be the going, well, part of it's going to be going through employee handbook.
Yes, yeah, see, and I still don't.
And do we want to put that burden on the director to go through the employee handbook, or are we, somebody else going to step up?
Why? They're going to have to know it.
So that day is really them just going through the employee handbook and
going, reiterating everything.
And they can come up with.
Do we have the handbook yet, or is that what?
Like everything else. I backed off for that one. I was going to, but then I backed off.
Staff manual, is that what you mean? Not the same thing?
Yeah, because I'm looking at Barrington's right now.
Who's our editor-in-chief? Has our editor-in-chief gone through that yet?
What is that?
The employee handbook.
It's cards for him.
No, it's right here. I haven't even had one. I've got Barrington's, and I haven't even gone through it yet.
Okay.
Not even.
So should we write that on a piece of paper?
Who?
You? D. Dan?
For what?
How long do
editor
you have
machine?
to employ
you
in
done
book?
By?
What's that? When should we have it done by? Don't just... If you can write my 25 page paper, I'll write a book. I'll start the book. I just don't know if I don't want to commit to like doing the whole thing and finishing it.
What are we supposed to do with it?
Oh, this one is 36 pages. Oh. How lovely.
Can we just
need to take the one that she has in Barrington and make it.
Yeah, you still have to make
just
it ours, but you have to go.
It.
Oh, sexual harassment policy, that's nice.
And we have to make sure it complies with this town's one,
right,
too.
Right.
We have to figure out what's.
Can we just. How about I do that part?
You want to take this?
Send it to me. Because it has to.
How
if
do
you
have
create
to
that,
changes?
Then it has to go through us anyway, so.
Yeah.
I'd rather you not create it, but
yeah, this has everything in it from sexual harassment to tips on talking with a camper.
Yeah.
Handling conflict, discipline, procedures, behavioral management policies in there again. They need to know that.
Yeah, I'll send you.
Okay. You can just sign up for that. It's awesome.
I'm just cutting and pasting. It's good. Good.
It's all good.
Well,
I already know the town
task. I would say, is there
a copy?
We already
have an employee policy.
Maybe.
So, your employee policy, we already have a town employee policy. Mm-hmm. All I need to do is take their rec room and add to, like, here's your employee policy.
Yeah.
You're a rec person. Here's your job.
You're just adding the things particularly having to do with supervising kids.
Because I'm not redoing our town employee policy. And then if you create a whole other policy, it has to go through the select board. And
all right.
Yeah, we have enough on it, too.
So I have a question. I'm going back a little bit to the school thing. You said you have a key. And
it's a fob, yeah.
A fob. And we were talking about the director would get one. But we also said that the director will open and the assistant director will close.
And I think we can talk to Keane about that.
I took it out.
Because I think they have more than, they have more extra.
So it's like saying, please tie concrete to my feet.
Yeah. Look at getting maybe two keys, one for the director and one for the assistant director, so that the person that opens doesn't necessarily have to be there all day to close, too. Didn't we say we were staggering by assistant director and director?
I'm just going back.
I'm used to thinking.
Staff orientation.
Yeah.
I'm going to tag one.
Yeah.
I'm not going to put a name on here now. But
yeah. That's fine.
Yeah. Yeah. Buddy up.
We'll give her
some. Yeah, oh, our bucket's filled. I'm so happy. Who's our talent demo?
That got rolled into... camp activity coordinator.
No,
that's Kathy and Celia.
I will send this back out now that it's updated.
Okay.
Who's gonna run?
Great question.
I mean, I.
Who's running what?
The orientation. Who's like?
Determining what is part of the orientation and.
Yeah.
Didn't we decide the director is?
Mm-hmm. But then. They need a little training beforehand.
Yeah, we need a good talking to the director.
I think we
need
to
at some point
know
we have
to go to the school.
It's a lot to for them to remember in like one day and then train some the next. They're all
okay.
going to be new.
Well, we'll make
well
yeah.
I think Susan.
She knows everything that's going on.
Kelly, let it be
yes.
a takeaway for you and I to talk about how we're going to do this with the director versus orientation and training versus paying them versus are they giving us more than 16 hours that we're paying them for? So let's you and I figure that out.
It's going to be on the man here.
So I have a question about, because I think we're all about dead. When do we think our next meeting is going to be? I didn't think we had one down.
It's not posted yet.
Because we only did up until today.
Yeah,
right?
But we had discussed that we can't take any time off, so we were going to go right through April.
27th.
Right.
I'm
on.
April 23rd is Sunday, right? Right?
It is.
I will
not be here.
What day is that?
I will be on the beach. In Puerto Rico.
Thinking
well,
about
what's the
summer
what's the Sunday
the summer
should we go? Well, what's the Sunday?
The Sunday after that is the 30th.
Sunday before
I will certainly be here for that if we want to.
Easter the 23rd. 30th is the.
No, Easter is the 16th.
30th is the.
What's the scoop at the.
What's the scoop? Yes.
What's the scoop? At?
The 30th is the.
Oh, yeah.
Three.
I didn't write
four.
That down, did I?
Yep.
From 1 noon to 4?
Scoop.
1 to 4.
That's it.
I'm tired. I forgot.
So
about
are we
going to
do the 30th?
I think we can.
That's 3.
That's 3 weeks out.
Oh, we could do. Could we
if
do
you
the,
guys want to go. If you want to go ahead and that way, I'm okay with that.
We could do the 23rd. Without Kelly and
yeah.
Wasn't there another day that one of us
could
do
Skype me
like
in?
Monday,
we'll Skype her in.
Oh, great.
I love Margarita.
It was like Sunday. Not that I'm
U.S. and just saying,
woo!
What time is that?
It's
1 to 4.
I'll volunteer for everything.
Put me down.
We really need to have a candidate by then or.
Yeah. Well, what are you saying? So the 23rd?
By the 30th. Well, if we were to meet on the 30th.
Whenever. Yeah, we need to, hopefully.
I mean, maybe not necessarily
I'll
someone
contact
I.
Contact this guy. Andrew, again. Andrew Gray. I don't know, has anybody ever heard of him? Andrew Gray is the person that I, and we haven't talked, so I don't.
What person?
He was interested in the director position, so we played phone tag a few times, and I just said, well, you know, the application is not, I have no idea because we've never talked. So,
you might want to check in with Kate Lucas, because when I gave her the form, she said she was going to send it to some people that she knew electronically.
Huh?
And see.
Well, I haven't heard from this guy, so I hope he didn't change his mind. So that would be the other thing. So I'll just tell him, all right. Are you still interested? Do we need to talk? So I'll do that. To do.
So, next meeting.
Is that on my list?
23rd or 30th?
Yeah, what do you guys want to do? With or without me, I really won't be offended.
I say we stick to the 23rd and go every 2 weeks. And,
I'll be here on the 23rd.
You will not be able to have a meeting on the 7th unless somebody else lets you in, because that's my kid's first communion.
So that's
that
the following.
That's
the following meeting if we go every 2 weeks.
If you go every 2 weeks.
If we go to the 30th, that will absolutely.
You can do another day, but.
Oh, well, there you go, because the Sunday after that is Mother's Day.
Wait, when's Mother's Day?
Yeah, write this down, Lester.
The 14th
of May.
So I'm actually going to read that.
Random week next.
All right, so do we decide? We decided the 23rd, though, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So why don't we
keep me included?
We'll do the 23rd, and then at the next meeting we can decide the next one, whether we're going to go the 7th or the 14th.
Well, we can't do the
7th.
So we can't do the 14th.
Unless you can get somebody else with a key to bring, let you in.
Yeah.
So.
23rd is the next one.
And then,
does it, would anybody
have more
do we need to continue on Sundays? I mean,
can we do another? Yeah. When we first started, there was somebody who
yeah,
could
do Monday
night
to the planning room without
some.
Syria, so.
she's gonna be fine.
Denise, she can't do weekends, so she was listed as an alternate this year.
I can't do Monday
unless it's...
Not doing Sundays anymore? Is that what we're talking about?
Well, just for like maybe, I don't know.
To get through the...
Because even with Jody on the 7th, like we could do it on the 6th. We have a meeting on the 6th. I'm out of town. I'm taking my kids to Edenville that weekend.
Wednesday night?
Same time.
At 3 o'clock. I'm good.
Wednesdays
are really tough.
Tuesday?
I'm okay Tuesday.
Tuesdays are good.
I'm good actually now on Tuesdays and Thursdays because I'm not coaching right now.
So does anyone have issues with Tuesdays?
What? I usually do. I get a brings over to choir practice. It's at 5:45. So I can have my mother bring her and pick her up. What day?
I think we were just...
You talk about going forward.
Kind of brainstorming to see if that would work. I don't know if we...
Yeah, after May 16th, choir ends anyway, so...
We could do Tuesday, May 9th, right? we could do Tuesday, May 9th, and then just go back to Sundays.
Let me double check, make sure that... Is that planning board meeting night? Is it the first Monday or first
that
Tuesday
would be
or second?
That would be the second one. They're meeting May 2nd.
If they meet the first Tuesday. Okay, so the 9th is okay.
So right now we're doing the 23rd.
At 7, here.
Without her, and then we're doing 9th.
What time are we talking?
May 9th.
For the 9th. Do you want
7?
Whatever you want.
Seven.
Just keep it 7.
7 is easy for me, because they're
okay.
Just about in bed.
Let's
then.
Do that then.
May 9th
at 7.
May 9th at 7. What?
So April 30th.
No, okay. It'll be okay.
What time?
6:45, so, yeah, I'll have my mother pick her up.
So I should take all,
alright. No, I'll have my mother.
I need all these Sundays off my calendar then.
What movie?
No, we're just,
no,
we're just moving
Tuesday.
One Tuesday.
We're moving
one,
and then we're going
sorry,
back to the
I'm
21st.
Tired.
Right?
Okay.
We
yelling at her!
And then we go back to May 21st, Sunday night.
And that way
Memorial
we don't have to meet Mother's
no,
Day.
No, it's not Memorial Day weekend.
Yeah,
that would be. Yeah? Yeah, no. That this falls, it
right,
makes
so.
It so it doesn't fall over. So we're back to Sunday the 21st.
Alright,
so I'm just going to move down.
Yeah.
So 23rd, 9th, 21st.
Yeah. Look good?
Okay, I'll get them posted.
Okay.
Let's stop there.
I have one more thing about the, I reached out to Tia, sent her an email to see if she needed help with the ice skating rink or, and thanked her for all of her hard work, and I haven't heard back.
Okay.
And I asked if she needed to be reimbursed for the minor.
And you haven't heard anything?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I haven't heard from Tia, actually.
And that's for, that's,
she
changed
the website,
like, $1,000 or something.
Did you see that?
Was it her
website?
Oh, I texted
Tia. Yeah, I did not
so
text.
So, could Winter Rec, she doesn't have
to
spend that $1,200 on, like, air hockey and a pool table, and then Summer Rec borrow it from them?
What?
Never mind.
Who had a pool table? I was putting the stuff in the phone, I'm sorry. What?
Never mind.
Okay.
Where took the money that Tia has?
She doesn't need it.
She asked for it, right?
Yeah.
The liner, but she has
it's a Winter Rec line.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So
you have
it.
Very
impressed
with
your line. You can use it any way you want.
So we could
look. I'm so
lucky.
If she doesn't need it or want it,
so she knows, like,
use that money to buy pop-ups for rec.
Basketball.
Hey, I have some of these that might help
ice
you.
Rink.
License.
Whatever you guys want to use it for.
Open license.
It's like it was designated for a client.
For those
Miss Lady.
But if it appears it's made and donated.
And Celia?
Yeah,
I don't
she's
know
ready
if
to
want
so.
So I do have one more.
Oh, I have
some
more.
Do you have some of this?
Have you
been there?
No, but I have 3 catalogs at home I forgot to bring.
So I was just down at Elliott for lacrosse practice, and
if we want, and I'm tabling this till after we are done with this, but Elliot has some really awesome senior programs that I mean, pages long.
Oh, I've looked at their kids' programs.
So I mean, it's really pretty neat what they have. So maybe we can look. Although, as I looked at it, it all has to do with food. Like they go, to breakfast and
lunch. Wow. It's like,
so we can hold on to that.
So you know,
yeah. All right.
Just one quick thing
before
we adjourn, and then we're done. Just so you guys know, Denise put us on that email for Family Fun Day because she was considering us being there, which we'll talk about in another meeting.
Okay.
On that topic, do you want to leave them figure out the day, or do you want us to make a recommendation? Because
I thought it was going to
be the same day.
No. Personally, to me, I think it is up to Denise. It is hers. It is her 401k. A 401k. 401c3. As a helper, but it's her thing. That's how I look at it.
She put out there that September 9th would work for her, which would be moving in a week early. And I feel follow that recommendation, say, if that date works for you, we'll be there to support you September 9th.
See, I think it's her baby, and it's her thing.
It's the second Sunday.
Yeah. So I can write that if you want, or if you want.
After.
Motion to adjourn.
Thank you, everybody.